Next question is from Mike Helm 7. I'm bulking, but I feel like I'm getting fat. Help.
Sound like Sal.
Yeah.
It's the Sal right now. Huh?
But does he look like Sal? Maybe, because he says getting fat.
No, I think this is really such a fine dance, right? When you are trying to put weight on or put size on, is, you know you need to eat in a calorie surplus. But I think that it took me a very, very long time before I got comfortable with how little of a surplus I needed in order to bulk and put size.
Totally.
On. Because nothing is more frustrating for the skinny guy or girl who's trying to build muscle and is, you know, pushing the calories and lifting every day, and then they wake up one morning and they're lighter. The scale is lighter than what it was 2 days ago.
Or they gain like a pound in a month.
Yeah. That really messed with my head for a very long time when I was trying to bulk. And so I was always just overstuffing and overfeeding during the bulk. And then I would just put on way too much body fat. So, you just got to be, if you have good programming, so if you're following a MAPS program and you're eating, even in the slightest bit of a surplus, I promise you, you're bulking. You're probably putting muscle on. And if you're not seeing the scale move, that's okay. There's probably a very nice exchange. You're probably even leaning out a little bit, and then you're also adding a little bit of muscle. Do not let yourself get caught up in what the scale is reading. If you got good programming and you're eating in a surplus.
Are you getting stronger?
Right. I mean, that's the best indicator. Things,
yeah. Getting stronger is a great one. It's not completely foolproof because sometimes getting fatter changes your leverage and it does make you a little strong. Like my squat will go up if I gain body fat for some reason. I just can squat more weight. But look at general. Am I stronger in all my lifts? If there's a yes there, that's positive. Like Adam said, have a good workout. You can be in a calorie surplus, have a great diet. If your workout's not stimulating muscle, you ain't going to gain muscle. You're just going to gain body fat. MAPS Anabolic and MAPS Strong, in my opinion, are the two best bulking, muscle-building programs, generally speaking. So if you're looking for a good program.
Or aesthetic.
Aesthetic can be great, too. A little more advanced, though, right?
Right.
Yeah, a little more. But for the average person, I'd say Anabolic or Strong would do it. Aesthetic, great if you're experienced.
I mean, no matter what, I don't care how experienced you are, I would go Anabolic first and then either to Strong or Aesthetic as the second program and then the other one for the third.
And then as far as surplus is concerned, you don't need a massive surplus to gain muscle. Let me put it this way. Gaining a pound of muscle a week would be remarkably fast bulking. I mean, that's like super genetics, muscle building. I don't expect that to happen in anybody except for maybe a beginner with decent muscle building genetics. But let's just say for hypothetical reasons, you could gain a pound of lean body mass. How many calories and grams of protein and carbs and fats do you think it really would take your body to gain that pound of muscle? It's not much at all. It's like 50 extra calories a day or less or something like that. So you don't need the huge surpluses. So if you're getting fat, you're probably eating too much, and I would look at your workout. If you fix those two things, then you'll fix this problem.